did this is giving all the resource from the pilot to monitor and be able to handle any specific situation.
Easier to get.
Easier, definitely. When we train pilots on this cockpit that never had any experience on last cockpit, in the beginning they feel it's a little bit more difficult. But very quickly, as soon as they get a bit of experience, they understand how easy it is to fly such an aircraft. I tell you, you will make rotation, pulling on the control and take off. Okay?
Pat, video on it, Pat. Video on it.
We was ready?
Alright, yeah.
Let's take off. Doesn't look much.
It's incredibly realistic, isn't it?
So the good point, let's see what happens when we are flying and we are losing an engine.
Come on.
Okay, so the pilot is having some warnings. And there we have one engine which is dead, lost. It's not even on autopilot. When you are on autopilot, barely you will not realize that you have lost an engine. Of course, the performance is reduced, so the aircraft will not go as fast as it flies on two engines. But in terms of safety, flying one engine is absolutely no problem. And especially with some of the new automatism we have on this aircraft, the control of the flight is handled by itself on the autopilot, and it's very transparent. That's quite very interesting. Okay, we can continue to fly to do this.
Go ahead.
So do not put the nose down. That's it. Okay, what I will do, I will restart the engine.
So all these controls are exactly the same as inside a 600?
From the 500?
This is the 600 though, isn't it?
This is the 600. Yeah. Talking about, sorry.
Now, all the controls in this simulator are exactly the same as a...
Oh yeah. This front part exactly is a pure cockpit,
right?
Aircraft cockpit. We could take it and put it in an aircraft and fly the aircraft. Right. It's aircraft parts.
Right.
And then, of course, there is the link with the electronic of the simulation to provide everything and create the reality. Let me quickly start this engine for landing.
Oh, it's done well.
1,000 meters runway. This is regulation point of view.
Right.
So, for example, that means that we have to land in 60% of the runway. So when we're talking 1,000, actually we're only talking about 600. Mm. And if we can make 600, that means that in real life actually we make something like 400. But you cannot reach a 400 meters runway by the regulation point of view, it's not acceptable. But technically speaking, that's about what it takes to land the aircraft. For maximum.